j.schreck.
And John.
John didn't say nothing very quick, did he? Is he frozen? Are you frozen, John?
Not yet, but I'm working on it.
We're in a location today that a gentleman, Bob, off of Facebook told me about, and it had some incredible walls and also some materials and some monos. And it kind of looks like maybe a combination of places, because it looks like maybe there's some sheep pens, but then there were definitely ancients in this area. And you know, we are on the Black Mesa. So definitely look at this beautiful day we've got. It's a little breezy. I'm not going to say it's not, but we're going to take a walk over in here and see what we can't find. See what is over in this vicinity. From the pictures that I saw, there were hundreds of materials. So we're going to make our way over. The road in was a little sketchy, but I mean, the road over was basically just common Black Mesa, Perry Mesa. It's pretty much all it was. I mean, if you look around this valley that we're in right here, you know, we're basically in kind of a standard, you know, Perry Mesa, Black Mesa landscape, tall grass, volcanic rock, cat claw, and extremely hard to walk in, soft, just the basic standard soil. And we're going to come down here and take a look, try to see what we've got in this area. Well, already, so we come down this rock cliff. So we're walking down here, and the first thing we see right here is grinding holes. You know, material's right here. So already coming down here, we have found signs that there were ancients down in this area. So already looking through here, and this is really extremely well worn right here already. So if we take a look in here, we study this. This whole rock has been worked. I mean, it's really been worked through here. So we're already, you know, 30 yards from the truck, getting into some stuff that is pretty unique already. So if we work our way down this canyon, it's going to be amazing at what we see. You know, the first thing that I see coming through here is we're starting to see some walls. So I'll be real curious to what kind of walls we're running into. But there were definitely walls through here. And again, I'm looking at maybe a mix of different cultures through here. And I'm not really sure, because here is definitely walls that have been constructed through here. Look at that. Now this is really cool. Look at this. I don't know what this was, but this is spectacular right here. This is spectacular. Look at that. That is really neat. So you can see these walls through here that were definitely built. Whether this was done by a rancher or by ancients right now, it's really hard to tell at this point. That's a hell of a wall though. People that follow me know that I love these walls, and these are some of the nicest walls I've come across, regardless who built them. Look at that. and the depth and the thickness is incredible. And you can tell this area right here, you know, holds a lot of water. Now, I'm not sure what the purpose of either one of these walls were. I'm kind of in amazement. This is really, I have lately been hitting a plethora of watering holes that have really ended up turning out to be really cool. I don't understand all of them. Like this, I do not understand why this is built like this all the way around. But it is really, really cool. Look at that. Let's go up this wall here and see if we can't take a look. I want to show you guys kind of the complexity of this and the thickness. You know, John, I'm not, look at the complexity of this wall here. Now it went, man, I'm not. If you broke a rock.
I broke one.
If you broke a rock.
I made it unstick.
This is one of the nicest walls I've come across, regardless of who built it, and regardless of what time, if it was, even if it was a rancher or an ancient or, those are big rocks. They move some big rocks. Absolutely of black mesa walls. Same thickness, same kind of structure. Same kind of fill, but definitely an area that's held water for a long, long time, which would have been critical. You know, so as we deduct this location, you know, a couple things, you know, we've seen grinding locations. We've seen some walls, which could be ancient or could be cowboy walls, could be sheep herder walls, but we know we've got ancients here too. So the second thing now I'm looking for is some type of clue about shards, things like that. So what else is there here as we scour this kind of area right here? And I'm seeing those walls on the very top, but I think it's best we kind of run through this valley. And I'll show you what we're going through right there. John's on that side. There he is. And then I'm walking through here, trying to find any other things that would signify any type of shards, anything like that, to kind of give us a little more clues on what we're getting into here and you know, who we were dealing with. So we've come up on this wall. Look at this wall as it goes across and it goes across here. You can see it over there going up. So they definitely had some type of pin right here. A little break in the wall right here. We can get across without hurting the wall. And look, now I can tell you one thing. This would have been a perfect place to put crops. So could they have possibly been growing crops and then this was the wall to keep animals out? Because this is a perfect area for some type of crops down here for sure. This whole area through here. So you've got somewhat of a pen as you walk around through here. And it's a pretty incredible sight. And this grass is just totally different through this little field here. And here's the wall that would have went all the way around, all the way through here, all the way up. See it coming down and up and around? And then up here, wow, this is an incredible wall. Just incredible. And again, I'm looking the ground right here. Is there any shards of any type? Well, there's our first indication right here that there's ancients here coming up this hill, which now this would have been a water hole 800 to 1,000 years ago, just like the newer generations of people coming through, whether it be the sheep herders or whoever, you know, they would have picked the same locations. Because here's the walls wrap around. Wow. This is unreal. This is absolutely unreal. And again, I see no shards. So we've got Mateos, and we've got walls, and we've got petroglyphs of some form. Now maybe that's a clue right over there. Because that's more of a structure that is more later history. This looks more of like a house. This would have been some type of house foundation right here, which might give us a little more of a clue on what we're dealing with. Now, one of the clues that I'm getting right now in this structure is it doesn't look like it's been dug. Which, if this was an ancient site, then they would have dug these corners. And it doesn't appear that the corners have been dug. We definitely know from the grinding holes that this slot was definitely an area that ancients used as well. We've already seen the petroglyphs to believe that. Nice cornerstones. And so right now, this specific area I'm looking at is some type of pens. I'm gonna guess sheep. But you know, I don't know that to be a fact. But I can tell you, whoever built those walls, they built a hell of a wall. Now, it's a pretty spectacular place for sure. So as we go down, let's look farther into this to see if we can't figure out, you know, just who we're dealing with. But like I said, I saw clues that ancients definitely had been here. And, you know, it's a pretty spectacular location. It really is. Oh, look at these. Look at this. My gosh. Dang, look at that. Now we're dealing ancients right here. Look at that. Unbelievable working up here. No, just working that they worked these rocks. Yeah, I saw one down there. But that means that there's got to be a lot more, you know, as we wind down a little bit. But they really worked the tops of these rocks. I mean, I've never seen anything like it. Now there's petroglyphs right there. You couldn't see them, but there they are right there. They're not as prominent, but you can tell that they worked these rocks here for hundreds of years. Now that we've missed that, let's take a look over here, see if these rocks here have been worked. So we have found this rock here. Look at all of the structures. I mean, here, here, and then on this rock here, and then on the back side of that rock, they're all over. And then right here, this is an interesting one here. So let's get over here, because here is, look at that. Okay, that's a big deal right there. That's been ground out. And then this right here has been worked out. So here we are. Now we've put a connection now. Now we've connected the ancients. I feel comfortable with the location. What we haven't been able to do really is connect the walls. And you know where the walls, an afterthought of the next generation of people up here. And I'm gonna say yeah, because that looks more like a herding wall right there. So it's like they herded them into this pen from the lower pen to the upper pen, and they had a herding chute. So I'm gonna go that these are sheep herders right here, but they chose this location because the ancients were here because of the water. And probably the grass that's in here through here is really unbelievable. But if you go through here, yeah, look at this. Look at that old can. There's, we just put a cowboy in, or a miner in this location by this can right here for sure. So, and that's been sitting there a long time. Now look at this wall here. So you got a lower pin down here, and what you're doing is you're herding the animals through here. And this does look exactly what this is through here. So I feel pretty comfortable. We're in a location that a lot of different cultures used. I think that's kind of neat. I really do. You know, that one of the funnest things about doing this is trying to deduct what you're finding, you know, thinking about the history, thinking about what life was like. And you know, if it wouldn't have been for the sheep walls, this is what I'm going to guess they were, maybe cows, but probably sheep, you know, I wouldn't have seen that they just took over or repurposed a place that the ancients had been at, because we are seeing signs of their work. We're seeing that point there was a big deal to them. They spent a lot of time on that point. The amount of rocks that were ground down were pretty incredible. So I'm expecting all over this area for there to be signs that they were here. So I'm gonna work my way down that ridge. Well, look at that. Of all things that you would not expect to see in the canyon, we see in the canyon. Look at that circle right down there. Do you see it? I never would have thought in a million years there would have been a rock down there with a circle on it. You know, on another day, we would find a waterfall right there. Look at a natural dam right there. Isn't that beautiful? And then right down at the very bottom, you see that circle carved on that rock. Oh, look at that. There we go. See, there's the reason. There's the reason why they were here, right there. That is the reason. There is the water. Now that might be a seasonal tank, and it may not be, but look at that. That is incredible. That is incredible. So if my guess is right, we are going to find, look down in there. Look at that. Wow. It doesn't take a lot to be awe-inspired in the state of Arizona, if you want to be. These two rocks here look kind of funny down here by themselves. definitely look like something that might be worked, but they might have been just hanging over that thing for decades. Kind of get a look and see if we can see anything against these walls. Now look at there. Look at the writing on these walls right there that I didn't see before. Look at that. Those are pretty intriguing. Pretty intricate as they walk down that wall right there. Got up on that point. They look like they got on the point across there too. Those are interesting glyphs right there. Very interesting. Hard to tell what they are, but it just goes to show you that any of these walls down here. Oh, look at that. Oh my gosh. Look at this. I would have missed this. Look at that up there. Oh my gosh. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that grooves right there. Look at that. I didn't see that. So they set it at this very location and did all kinds of work on these rocks across this ridge right here. So that is just beautiful. Look at those ridges. Conducive to petroglyphs, even though I know that the rock specifically wasn't the reason and that I believe to be the location. But look at this. Look at this here. This is beautiful. Just beautiful. Just to find these little oases. You know, I had a guy say that, you know, it wasn't an oasis, I guess, unless it's always got water, which I can see. But you know what? If it's got water when I need it, that's an oasis. Look at this. Boy, this is a sacred place. Definitely. And so why would I say that? You just get these feelings that you're in a place and you're up here and you're like, my gosh, how cool is this? So we're gonna, now this kind of is one of those altar type outcroppings. Look at there. Definitely was a location. This panel here as well. You can really see it right in here. There's, looks like a man there. So the good news is we've had plenty of time today to be able to really go over this area pretty well. Let's get a stick to help us out. See if we can tell how deep that is. Okay, that's pretty deep. That's pretty deep. That'll hold water for a while. Right there. I can just see them sitting on these ledges. Just through here, I just can. As I walk up this creek, and here's, these appear to be, yeah, maybe not on those. It's, that's a hard one to tell. I think we need to look at that ridge up there as we walk through here and see what else is, those have been worked right there. Whatever shards were here at one time have definitely been washed away. We walk back this way, see what's over here. So we definitely got into another area, another kitchen, I like to call it. So back again. So they were definitely, and there we go. Here's more rock art right here. a man right there, that corner. There's a nice one right here. Look at that. Nice deep one right there. So we've got another work area right here. And then, looky there. Looky there. Looky there. See, now we've got into petroglyphs again right here on this point. So now look at all these grinding locations right here. And then right here. And then look at all this work here. Right there. Okay. And there is a, here's a cool one right here. So this slab broke off sometime, I believe, right here. Did it break off, or did they do the petroglyphs here, or did it break off somewhere there? Now look at this location right here. Then here, here, oh, look at that. Look at that right there, that circle. Tell me that isn't cool. So we definitely got into a hotbed of areas that they're working. How neat is that? Look at that right there. Look at that. They're all over. This was definitely a hotbed of, look at this, up here. Wow, they were all over this area. John! They were all over this. These rocks in this location grinding up on this hill. Look at that. Look at this. This is, look at that one on this point. There's one there. Look at this one right here. Wow. Look at this. Man, I tell you what, this is an incredible point here. This is a kitchen. This is the real deal right here. Look at these, they're everywhere. Man, there was an army over here working this. Definitely an army working this area. Look at these, are just incredible. This is the most incredible. This is probably the most incredible kitchen I've ever seen doing this ever, anywhere. Anywhere. As much as Brooklyn was, or strong as Brooklyn was, nothing like this. There's definitely a grinding area right here. Look at that. And then look at the depth of this one. Then they're working here. They're working here. Crossway and back, there must have been some style. But you don't grind a solid rock unless you have look at that, there's another one. And then we're seeing a few glyphs on the wall, not a ton, but and then more of it's grooves. Like here, that's what we're seeing. And then this location here, look at that. You know, I was told that this was loaded, and they absolutely were not lying to me. You know, one of the things we kind of promised ourselves was that we was going to take a minute when we're up here and just stop and just kind of look and contemplate, you know, what life would have been like, whether it be the sheep herders, whether it be the ancients up here, you know, what was this really about? So I'm gonna take a minute and just pan around and, you know, think about this place. Think about your life. Think about the things that you're trying to accomplish. Think about the things they were trying to accomplish. They all had a goal, you know. They all wanted to get a little better than just eat, right? So let's take a look. And I'm going to pan around for a minute. You know, I hope you enjoyed today. It was really cool getting in here and seeing something a little different. And if it wouldn't have been for those walls, you know, it wouldn't have drawn anybody in here. It just goes to show you, up in this area, there's stuff everywhere, you know. So there's still a great place to explore. It's still a great place to go out and have an adventure. You know, if you like what you see, please like. Please subscribe, and please hit that notification bell. And you know, hell, if you want to buy us a tank of gas, we'll take it. If not, we're still going out. But you can hit that the button on top of the page, and you can send a donation if you'd like. And regardless, you're much appreciated. Have a great day today, man, and go out and get outside and enjoy this place we call home. J.schreck, Black Flag Expeditions. Look at this crazy place we get to call home. Man, look at that.